In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make an Autoclicker macro with Razer Synapse. Start by opening the Razer Synapse software. Locate the module's heading and open the macro option. If you don't see the macro option, then you will need to install the macro module. We will include a tutorial on how to fix this issue in the description. There are several different types of autoclickers, so we will be covering them all. You can use the video chapters to find the type of macro that you would like to use. The first type of autoclicker is a rapid-fire macro. A rapid-fire macro will quickly repeat an input and is typically used to automatically shoot a single fire weapon when gaming. Start by clicking the plus icon in the macro panel. Click on the macro name. Name the macro as you like. I'll be calling mine Rapid Fire. Hit enter to confirm your name. Make sure you have the macro selected, then click the record button. Wait for the timer to count down. Then click the left mouse button once. Feel free to use a different input for your macro if you'd like. Stop the recording. You will now have two macro events. Select the first macro event. In the properties menu, you will notice a delay. Highlight the delay and set the value between 0.01 and 0.10. Be sure to press enter on your keyboard to confirm. Select the second macro event. Set the delay between 0 and 0.10. I'll be using 0.02. Click enter to confirm the delay. At the bottom, you will notice a clock icon with a time. This is the complete run time for your macro. You can adjust your delay values to control this time. The lower the number, the higher your CPS or clicks per second will be. We will have the run times for different click speeds on the screen. Click the plus icon in the keybind section. Select the device you want to use the macro on. I'll be using my keyboard. Choose the button that you want to use for the macro. Some Razer devices have a hyper shift function, which allows you to bind a function to the second layer of keys. Expand the playback options menu on the side. Select the Play While Assigned Key is Pressed option. This will play the macro on a loop while the assigned button is held down. Once lifted, the macro will stop. If you would prefer to enable and disable the macro like an on-off switch, then select the toggle option. Click Save. Your Rapid Fire macro will now be working in Razer Synapse. Head back to the Razer dashboard. Select the device you want to use for the autoclicker. Choose the button or key you want to use. Switch to the mouse function options. Make sure that left click is selected from the drop menu. If you want to use a different key for your rapid fire macro, then select it here. Enable turbo. This will allow the function to repeat while held down. Drag the slider to the speed you want it, with the maximum CPS being 20. Save. Your new rapid fire key will now be working. Head back to the macro page. Next, we will be making an AFK macro. An AFK macro will play a button or click on repeat until turned off. This type of macro is typically used to prevent being logged out of a game or software. Click the plus icon in the macro panel. Select the new macro title and name it AFK. Press enter on your keyboard to confirm the name. Next, you need to decide what button or key you want to use for the AFK macro. Usually, the left click or spacebar works best. You can also use a combination of inputs if needed. Click the record button and wait for the time to disappear. Press the key that you want to be used for the macro. If you are using a combination, then press the keys and buttons at the speed you want them to be replayed at. Once you have finished, click the stop button. You will now see your macro events. If you use the combination, then you can skip to the timestamp on screen, or follow through to adjust your macro timing. Select the first input. Highlight the delay and set it to the time you want to be used between each input. For my example, I want it to click every 5 seconds, so I'll be setting it to 5. We will have some common times on screen. Either leave the second event delay as is or set it to 0. Click the plus icon in the keybinds panel. Choose your Razer device. Select the button you want to use for the macro. I'll be using a hypershift key. Set the playback option to toggle continuous playback. Save. You will now be able to turn on and off the AFK macro using your selected button. Pressing it once will start the macro, and pressing it a second time will stop the macro. The macro can be modified at any point without having to reset the keybind. The last autoclicker that we will be setting up will use mouse movement to complete repetitive tasks. For this example, I'll be creating a macro to enable and disable developer mode on Discord. Click the plus icon in the macro panel. Select the new macro and give it a name. Expand the downwards arrow next to the record button. If you want the macro to loop, then click the box at the top and assign a shortcut key. You will need to use the shortcut to start and stop the macro recording. At the bottom, you will see three options for tracking the mouse movement. Screen tracking will use an absolute position on your screen. This method is best for using multiple programs at once. However, it tends to have issues on systems with multiple screens. The foreground option uses a relative position for an application that is in the foreground. This is useful for controlling applications that may be in a different position on your screen in the future. Finally, we have the start point option. This is typically the best method for mouse movement auto-clickers as it is less likely to run into issues. With this method, the mouse will move according to the position the mouse is in when the macro is started. I'll be using the start position macro for this example, and highly recommended this for most auto-clicker macros. Click the record button, then move your cursor to the starting position. We recommend trying to click in the middle of buttons or objects when recording the macro. This will prevent any issues if the starting point is off when playing the macro in the future. Perform the actions for the macro. Feel free to perform them relatively slow as you can adjust the speed of the macro later. If you want the macro to repeat on a loop, then be sure to move back to the start position at the end of the macro. Stop the macro. If you stop the macro with your mouse, then you will notice an extra mouse movement event at the bottom of the script. Select the event and press the bin icon to delete it. You can also delete all the events by clicking the top event, holding shift, clicking the bottom event, then pressing the bin icon at the bottom. Now, we will be adjusting the macro to speed up the automation. Each macro event has a delay on the left. This is the time between the previous event and the current event in seconds. You will notice that each button press has two inputs. The down arrow indicates a press, and the up arrow indicates a release. If you increase the release input, then it can result in a button hold. Typically, you will only want to lower the delay on a release. Select an input that you want to change the delay on. Highlight the delay in the properties menu. Enter your new delay in seconds. The lower, the faster the macro will be. Repeat this for all events. Mouse movement events also have a duration option. This is how long the actual movement takes. You can lower this to speed up the macro. If you want the auto-clicker to replay on a loop, then you will want to add a delay to the first script event. This will add a delay to the start and between each playback. Click the plus icon in the keybinds panel once you're happy with your macro. Select the device you want to use to activate the macro. Choose a button or key. I'll be using a hyper shift key on my keyboard. Set the playback option on the left. Play once will play the macro one time. Play multiple times will play the entire macro on a loop for a specified amount of times. Toggle continuous will play the entire macro on a loop, being turned on and off with a single click of your chosen keybind. This is essentially an on-off switch. Play while key pressed will loop the entire macro while the assigned keybind is being held down. Typically, for this type of macro, you will want to use either play once or toggle. Save. You will now be able to make rapid fire, AFK, and auto clicker macros with Razer Synapse.